Well, my friends, this is an interesting take from Chevrolet and the whole notion of saving the manuals. It's the 2018 Camaro ZL1 1LE, and it is perhaps one of the most satisfying ways of turning dinosaur juice into fury and speed. But if you're an introvert, this is not the car for you. In the few days I've been driving it, I've made a ton of new friends, run out of business cards, in fact, and you folks know who you are. You're gonna have to leave a comment below. Anyway, enough talk. Let's take this hot Camaro for a spin. Don't misunderstand me, this is a hardcore, no-compromise car. I mean, it was engineered to do one thing exceptionally well, and that's to go around any racing circuit as fast as many supercars. And, you know, with its Camaro record, Nürburgring lap time of 7 minutes 16 seconds, that, you know, as much as Nürburgring lap times are BS, making a 3,800-pound Camaro go around the Nürburgring in 7 minutes 16 seconds is very, very impressive. Indeed, this is not much of a road car. It's not much of a canyon carver, as we're doing here. This is really a track car. It is that hardcore. Of course, you got to talk about the drivetrain. This LT4 is awesome. Paired with a 6-speed manual and electronically controlled diff at the back, it is just fantastic. The drivetrain is just outstanding. The suspension as well is based around a set of Multimatic spool valve dampers. And if you're unfamiliar with those, well, two things. One, understand that they are found on the Formula One grid today for some very impressive technical reasons. And if you need a primer on spool valve dampers, well, we interviewed Multimatic's Larry Holt when we drove the Z28 a couple of years ago. So if you need a primer, the link is down in the description, and I'm going to throw it here on the screen for you as well. The tires are barely street legal. They're a new tire from Goodyear, and the brakes are outstanding as well. Two-piece rotors up front and massive Brembo calipers as well. And of course, it's pretty cool. They say 1LE on them. You can't ignore all the aero that's going on here. It's obvious. I mean, what's going on at the front with all the intakes and the massive grille and the splitter and the dive planes. I mean, the front end of this car looks like it's going to eat small children and dogs, and there's a legit carbon fiber wing out the back as well. What's also interesting is that it's a modern Chevrolet. There is up-to-date infotainment unit, automatic climate control, Apple CarPlay and Android Auto, and OnStar 4G LTE Wi-Fi. This ZL1 1LE is a little bit lighter than the regular ZL1, and that, of course, comes from a lighter wheel and tire package, as well as the Multimatic spool valve dampers. They replace the magnetic ride dampers that are in the regular ZL1, but the wheel and tire package is significantly lighter. They're 19s instead of 20s, I think, on the ZL1. And I got to talk about these tires. I mean, normally I'd say that, you know, they stick like plaid on a hipster, but hipsters are a bit fickle, and I'm getting tired of using them as an example. So all I can say is, holy Ron Fellows, they stick to the road, especially when they've got heat in them. They're a great all-around tire for this car. Not great in the wet, as I discovered, and certainly not great when they're cold, but they do have excellent breakaway characteristics. And, you know, when it's cold and maybe a little damp, you know, yaw can be controlled by the throttle and the steering quite easily. these Goodyear Eagle F1 Supercar 3R tires, I think they're called, are one of the secrets of the car. There's no question. They are barely street legal, and if you want to daily a car like this, which I wouldn't recommend, you're going to need a different tire. I mean, these are not great in the wet. They are definitely a track tire, and they're just barely street legal. The interior is familiar sixth generation Camaro, and you're set up with this fantastic seating position in the Recaro seat. I just sit perfectly in this car. The steering wheel is the right diameter, and it's got an Alcantara cover, which is awesome. But I think one of the most satisfying things about this car is your interaction with the six-speed gearbox. Yes, there is automatic rev matching, and that's really boring for, you know, drivers like me, but shifting this thing is an absolute joy. The shifter is fantastic. Clutch effort is reasonable given the amount of power that this engine makes. And you actually get a little bit of feel out of the clutch as well, so you can feel what's going on. But wow, I love going up and down this gearbox. And yes, you can heel and toe it. And no, you don't want to wear your racing shoes. Skate shoes are perhaps the better choice. One downside to this ZL1 1LE is the view at the back. All you see is this massive carbon fiber wing, and even right now there's a motorcycle following me, and I can barely see the motorcycle. So yeah, you can't see out the back window worth a damn. And all the time that supercharger whine is present, it's just there, reminds you that you are commanding that 650 horsepower LT4, and it's so much fun. By no means is this ZL1 1LE perfect. It may be the perfect road-going track car, but it's not the perfect road car. What I do find on the road is that the tire will actually leave the road surface on certain bumps from time to time. I think this car was really designed for the road. It's designed for the track, and I think that's where it really works best. So take that with a grain of salt, but as a road car, it rides very firm. For some people, especially, Prius drivers, for example, would think that this ride is punishing. It has been suggested that it should come with the kidney belt if you're driving on the road, but it's not ideal. It is very, very firmly sprung. There's very little body roll, and for drivers like us, it's a blast to drive, and I really, really want to try it on the racetrack, and I just haven't had the opportunity as of yet. The electric power steering is a bit interesting. Right now I'm in tour because I'm getting light steering effort, but if I switch to sport or track, the effort goes up, and of course, I don't know if you can hear the exhaust, but the exhaust note changes. And here, at least in track mode, when I'm turning in, just feels artificially heavy. It's still nice and quick, and you do get decent feedback through the car. I don't necessarily say you'd get a lot of feedback through the steering wheel, and for me, I'm not a steering wheel fetishist, so it's not that much of a concern for me. It's very precise and does what it's supposed to do. I'm actually enjoying steering this car, and I'm really not going to complain about the steering too much, except in track mode, it just feels artificially heavy. The real trick to this ZL1 1LE is how everything, all of these components, add up to something greater than their sum. It definitely meets its design objectives. It is spot on there. It is no compromise. It is hardcore, but everything works so well together. You've got this massive amount of power. You've got this great aero. You've got this very satisfying gearbox to row. The steering is fantastic. Seating position sets you up for success. I mean, the dampers are doing a great job, except on those rare occasions where they're not on some horrible roads that we're driving on here. But overall, it comes together very, very well. And what that does is it makes this car very approachable and very easy to drive quickly. And, you know, you don't have to be a pro-level driver to access most of this car's performance envelope. It's really, really well done. Never mind the aero. I mean, you've got that splitter up front, the dive planes up front, lots of cooling going on. Massive wing out the back. The aero in this car is very legit. And, you know, when it's paired with this massively powerful motor, this car doesn't get great fuel consumption. It's like driving around with a parachute attached to the back. I mean, it's not exactly like driving around with a parachute attached to the back, but it's pretty darn close. In my driving, I have been averaging 14.7 miles per gallon. I mean, that's with a lot of highway driving. It's absolutely punishing, but that's what this car is meant to do. It's meant to turn the dinosaur sauce into, you know, amazing noises and a whole lot of speed. But, you know, all I have to do is look at this car funny and I gotta fill it up again. Sure, there are plenty of track-oriented specials out there, but I think this one might be the most focused one of them all. It is seriously hardcore, seriously uncompromising, and what's very interesting is that, as I mentioned, you don't have to be a pro-level driver to access most of this car's performance envelope, and that's what makes it very, very special. Like I said, by no means is this the perfect car. It's probably better on the track than it is on the road, but it is a no excuses, no compromises track car. It does fulfill its design objectives, and kudos to Chevrolet for turning out an awesome car like this. It is just a blast to drive. It is exceptional, and I'm thrilled to have had the opportunity to drive this on some amazing roads. It has been a blast, and I really don't want to give it up. I really feel that there is an exceptional man-machine interface, driver-machine interface here. It is quite good, and it definitely is exceptional. I just can't say enough about this. It's a very, very special car. Thanks for hanging out with us today and having a look at this 2018 Chevrolet Camaro ZL1 1LE. Hope you liked this piece, and if you did, be sure to like it and share it with your friends and subscribe, because it's the only way this channel is going to stay on YouTube. And as always, we want to know what you think, so please leave a comment below. And I think we're going to hear a lot of opinions given the polarizing nature of this car. And if you think it's not hardcore enough, well, think again. I mean, this thing does absolutely meet its design objectives. It is absolutely meant for the track, and it's, in my opinion, just a little too hardcore for the road. And if you don't believe me, definitely try one out. If you are looking for something like this, just go ahead and buy one. It is really outstanding. Anyway, thanks again for watching, and we'll see you again next time.